all members of kingdom Animalia are multicellular, and they show different levels of organization, right from molecular level, cellular level, tissue level, organ level, and that develops into an organ system and an organism level. The main common characteristics of the kingdom Animalia, the heterotrophs, depend on different organisms for other organisms for their nutrition. The eukaryotic, multicellular, and the cells lack cell wall. The motile, they move from one place to another place, and they have sense organs. The evolution of mesoderm has led to the complexity of the organ system in animals. For example, in digestive system, as we are seeing in Nidarian sea anemone, there are same single opening for food as when the food comes in, and the excretion, that is the dianas, also is the same. But in higher organisms, from Ascalminthus to chordates, they have two different openings for food as well as anus, and this is a complete digestive tract. Similarly, circulatory system, there are two types, open and closed circulatory system. In the open circulatory system, the blood remains filled in the tissue spaces because of the absence of the blood capillaries, as I'm showing here, blood capillaries. So therefore, it remains filled in the tissue spaces. This type of open circulatory system is seen in arthropods, mollusks, echinoderms, and urochordates. Whereas in closed circulatory system, the blood flows, see the I'm showing here, the blood flows completely circulated through blood vessels of varying diameters, arteries, veins, and capillaries. And this type of closed circulatory system is seen in annelids, cephalochordates, and vertebrates. Kingdom Animalia is classified on the basis of major features of body plans, whether it is cellular level, tissue level, organ level, or organ level. Based on the symmetry, tissue complexity, this is on based on the tissue complexity. And symmetry, it can be radial or bilateral. And again, bilateral, it can be based on the coelom found in the animals. It is again, it can be acelomates, pseudocelomates, and coelomates. All these, under these categories, the kingdom Animalia is classified. We shall see all these levels one by one, all these phyla one by one now. But all the animals, you know, they are multicellular animals. An animal's body plan results from the animal's pattern of development. In sponges, as we are saying, the body is irregular, so the pattern of symmetry is asymmetrical. Radial symmetry, it is seen in sea anemone, as I am showing here. When the plane of axis passes through any part of the body from top to the bottom, it will divide the body from the top to the bottom into two equal halves. This is in jellyfish also, I am showing the picture here. Bilateral symmetry, this type of symmetry is seen in insects when the plane of axis passes through the center of the body. So the top or the bottom portion, anterior or the posterior side, anterior posterior side, dorsal and the ventral side, and the right or the left side, the parts too will be equally similar on the two sides. This is the bilateral symmetric pattern. The tissues and organs of an animal originate from two or three germ layers of its embryo. The embryo, the germinal layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. Based on how many layers are going to form the animal, it is called as a diploblastic or triploblastic animal. The developing embryo, if it forms, has two germinal layers, ectoderm and endoderm, it will be called as diploblastic. And if the developing embryo has three layers, the ectoderm, the mesoderm, and the endoderm, it will be a triploblastic animal. And between the ectoderm and the endoderm, an undifferentiated tissue, as I am showing here, this is an undifferentiated layer present. This is called as mesoglia. This type of mesoglia, this type of embryonic germ layer is seen in corals, jellyfish, and sea anemone. The animals develop from this type of embryos. The ectoderm forms the exoskeleton, as I am showing here in the picture, ectoderm, that is the outermost layer, germinal layer. And the mesoderm, it develops into the organ. The mesoderm is going to give rise to the organs of the organism of the animal. Endoderm, it forms the inner lining of the organs of the developing animal. Presence of body cavities or coelom is important in classifying animals. Animals, as we have learned earlier, they develop from ectoderm, endoderm and the mesodermal germinalis. If the body of the organism has no cavity between it, as I'm showing here, the white colored is a cavity, body cavity. If it is absent in organisms, such organisms will be called as acelomate. So this cavity is seen between the body covering, that is outer covering of the body, and the inner digestive tract. If such cavities are absent, those will be called as acelomate, and such organisms or animals will have a rigid body and with no free movement of the internal organs. As we have learned earlier, that the middle germinal layer, mesoderm, is responsible for the development of the inner organs of the animal. Coelomate, if the true coelom is found, that is the cavity is lined on both the sides by the mesodermal layers. Here, I am showing here, the red colored is the cavity and it is lined on both the side by the mesodermal layer. Then such organisms will be called as coelomate animals, example annelids. And in certain animals, pseudocoelomates are seen, that is the body cavity is not completely lined by the mesodermal germinal layer. Such organisms will be called as pseudocoelomate, as seen in nematodes or roundworms. This is the digestive tract. It is and then the cavity here. Here it is very clearly visible. The digestive tract, the cavity is on both the sides. It is lined by the mesodermal germinal layers. The body plants, either it is diploblastic or triploblastic, and then the cavities, whether it is acelomate or coelomate, the increasing levels of complexity, it is shown here, from the nerians to echinoderms, molluscs and chordates, we are seeing the increasing levels of complexity in animals. Based on the formation of the coelom, the eucoelomates or the true coelomate, the animals having the true coelom are divided into two types, schizocoelomate and entocoelomate. Schizocoelomate, the body cavity or the coelom is formed by the splitting of the mesoderm. Such type of animals are called as schizocoelomate, seen in Annelida, Arthropoda and Mollusca. Enterocoelomate animals, the body cavity is formed from the mesodermal pouches, of the archintron. Such animals are echinodermate and chordates. Now, what is an archintron? Archintron or the digestive tube, it is a digestive tube. It is develops into the digestive tract of an animal. So this archintron is going to give rise to the digestive tract of an animal. Based on the presence or the absence of the primitive backbone or primitive beginning to the backbone, notochord animals are classified as non-chordates and chordates. Notochord absent, the animals are classified as non-chordates. Notochord present, chordates. Animals lacking notochord are called as non-chordates. Again, in chordates, animals lacking a vertebral column are called as invertebrates. Notochord is the first skeletal structure to appear in the embryo. If that is a cartilaginous tissue, and only if the cartilaginous tissue notochord is present, the animals are called as invertebrates, protochordates, lower chordates, upper chordates, vertebrates. Around the notochord, if a bony vertebrae develop, which is going to give rise to a true vertebral column, the animals are called as vertebrates. No notochord, non-chordates. Notochord present, only cartilaginous tissue, the primitive beginning to the backbone, invertebrates. Vertebrates, notochord along with a bony vertebrae, the two vertebral column or the two bony skeletal structure, the animals are called as vertebrates.